And now, it's time to sit back and enjoy the Two True Freaks Internet Radio Broadcast.
Fox Kids is what?
Fox Kids is Zeo powered up.
Go, go, Power Rangers!
Zeo Ranger 1, pink! Zeo Ranger 2, yellow!
Zeo Ranger 3, blue! Zeo Ranger 4, green! Zeo Ranger 5, red!
Hello, everybody, and welcome to episode 114 of Ranger Chronicles. I am your host, Charlie Niemeyer, and once again, we are returning to the world of Power Rangers Zeo to witness two more exciting adventures of our power team. So we're going to get right to that right after this quick break.
The all-new Power Rangers Zeo is here and better than ever.
I think it's great.
With more action.
We've got the power.
More great adventures.
Special effects were really cool.
The other one was really cool, but this one's even better.
It's the best! I think the monsters are very cool.
They're powered up like never before. Power Rangers Zeo, all new tomorrow on Fox Kids!
All right, we're back in business. I got the DVD all queued up here. So we're going to start things now in 3, 2, 1, go! For Crying Out Loud was the fifth episode of Power Rangers Zeo, first aired on April 27th, 1996, written by Al Winchell and directed by Robert Redler. You notice they don't go inside the juice bar much. Well, they do, but they usually practice, like, karate and other martial arts. This isn't the best copy, either.
We have to hurry, Skull! Lieutenant Stone said if we're not there by 3 o'clock...
I'm watching the DVD, but there's, like, some echoing on the letters.
Assignment for us.
Don't worry, Bulky, nothing's getting in my way.
Something is. Oh, not a good idea. This is going to be... They're going to be like the police on the Dukes of Hazzard, aren't they? Oh, they're just going to go over the hill. Okay. Meanwhile, Lieutenant Stone's having a problem with a squeezable ketchup bottle.
Don't worry, Bulky. I know exactly where we are.
I see it. Then why aren't you turning?
I'm trying.
Oh, I like how the Bulk and Skull theme goes. Get that banjo and harmonica going. Well, what did I say about the Dukes of Hazzard a minute ago? Now, okay. She should not be hanging the clothes over mud puddles.
When I get my hands on those two.
Don't worry, we're almost there.
Those were, by the way, some of the stunt actors. Possibly some of the ones that wear the suits in other parts of the episode. Say something. Oh. Hey, the ketchup works now.
Now, for that special assignment.
Ew, it laid an egg in his mouth.
Yes, sir.
You two are in charge of textbook distribution.
Psychology.
Textbooks distribution? Really?
Hey, Tommy, we just heard the news.
Oh, funny. You guys are funny, man.
What's going on?
You mean you haven't heard?
I'm sorry, I didn't get you anything, Tommy.
Mr. Toggle wants us to do this report on family cares and relationships. So, we gotta pretend we're married for the weekend.
We?
Me and, Catherine.
I think you two make a lovely couple. I'm very happy for you.
Oh, thanks.
So where's your new bride anyway?
She's getting our baby.
She's supposed to meet me here. I don't know. She says she has this great idea on how to make this report a little bit more realistic.
There it is.
Are you allowed to bring a baby to school like that?
Looks like you not only have a wife, you have a baby too.
He's so adorable. Who is he?
He's a friend of the family. I babysit him all the time.
Everyone, this is Joey.
Hey, Joey.
Hi, Joey. I volunteered to watch him for a couple of days. Just think of the insight it'll give us for our report.
I'm sorry. It's just.
I don't know.
I'm so happy for you, Dad.
Whoa.
Oh no.
I just remembered that. There's something I gotta do.
You know what? I forgot. I have to cook tonight.
Yeah.
Go home.
They This is why you don't bring the baby into the study area at school.
Woo, gotta go. Hold it.
Almost, Tommy.
Where do you think you're going, Dad?
That's funny.
Yes, this gives me a magnificent idea, my dear.
Really? Then you must tell me all about it.
If this child's normal cry has such a disturbing effect, what do you think would happen if we increased his volume? Sprocket!
He'd get louder? What a mental midget!
Oh, Sprocket, you are so
very good.
Thanks! What do you think of that, Mr. Know-it-all?
What that king is trying to say is that sound waves can become a destructive force if properly used.
Huh? Yeah, like I didn't know that.
All of you, quiet! That infant has all of the ingredients that we need to destroy Angel Grove.
Might I suggest that we send Boohoo the clown? He's wonderful with children, you know.
Excellent idea, Clank. There may yet be hope for you.
Oh, thank you, my liege. Did you hear that, Orbus?
Good show.
Man, I never thought he'd fall asleep. Let's just hope he stays that way.
So are they staying at this... at Joey's parents' house?
It's about time!
Well, really?
I thought he'd never leave! Now, don't you worry, little baby. Boo, not gonna hurt you. It's those awful old Power Rangers we're after. Not an adorable little baby like you!
We're the Junior Police Patrol. The Junior Police Patrol.
Excuse us.
Excuse me. Hey, excuse me, where do you think you're going?
Look, excuse me, Bulk, but we gotta look something up on the internet, all right?
Listen, Daddy-O, this area has been designated as a no-cry zone. Hey, Tommy. Hey, mister, you can't be walking.
Come on, Bulk, he's asleep. If he starts to cry, I'll take him outside.
Well, what's up, Tommy? How's parenthood treating you?
Please.
All right, Cat.
Hey, we get Billy outside of the command center for once.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry, power chamber.
I've got her eye on you.
I mean, you gotta change him. You feed him. Hey, take it easy. I mean, come on, he's a little baby. How much trouble can he be?
Obviously, you've never been a parent yet.
Hello, little Joey.
No, don't.
Good job, Tommy.
This is not the time to panic. It's just a little tricky.
You know what I'm noticing? Haven't they converted the classroom and the hallway into this study room?
I think the baby's doing it.
Yeah. The louder it gets, the more we shake.
I've got his bottle. Here we go.
I think you gotta take Joey to the power chamber.
This could elevate the terrible twos to a whole new level.
Yeah. Anybody wanna guess who's responsible?
I think we're gonna need help with this one.
Is that the same baby?
To the power chamber and see if Zordon knows anything.
Rocky and I'll take Joey someplace with this list to destroy.
All right, we'll call you as soon as we know what's going on.
Okay.
Be careful, guys.
Don't just teleport because Bulk and Skull are... Okay. Bulk and Skull were just there. Aww.
Truth be told, this whole idea was mine, right, my lovely?
Yes,
that is true.
Really?
Now that that is settled, we know the plan works, so I will have Boohoo the Clown return and increase the destructive power of the baby.
Boohoo the Clown.
What's up, man? Well, the sonic frequency of Joey's scream was digitally captured by our satellite communications transceiver, so I was able to sample
sure.
it and create a continuous loop for research purposes.
So what are you saying?
Just cover your ears. Ready, Alpha?
Tommy didn't get that. Okay, so they caught it.
The frequency and amplitude of Joy's cry has been altered.
You said it.
You think?
Here's a before and after frequency comparison.
That baby crying is also not Joey.
It's almost off the chart. But how did Kimono do it? Well, that's the million-dollar question. If we can figure that out, we might be able to reverse the effects. Until then, we've got one dangerous baby out there.
Cat!
Keep it down.
Dummy.
Are you guys all right? As long as we can keep
you know, that looks like an outfit that Tommy might have worn in season one.
That's true.
Oh, I'm talking about what Adam's wearing.
I love about babies. Wake the little guy so he can give us a good wail.
Tommy, you better get over here.
Yeah, quickly.
Ay-yi-yi. The Boohoo monster is giving off the same frequency signature as Joey.
Well, I guess you found our answer. Tommy, you're gonna have to destroy that monster if Joey's gonna have any chance of returning back to normal.
Right.
Well, that's easy. We're already halfway through the episode, so that shouldn't be too hard. Oh, that's a cool effect.
Now that the gang's all here, let's have a party!
It's morph time!
Aw, man. Wait a minute.
Let's go, guys.
Pretty sure they took a better image of Tommy for the morph there, because he had his hair down. Maybe I saw it wrong. I can't go back now.
All right, let's shut this guy down.
They're not going to sing through this song, but it's fun. And now we're into O-Ranger footage. Sweet! Good job, Alpha.
I won't let you take that baby. No.
Yeah, I just want to borrow you. I'll give you back. After he helps us destroy Angel Grove, that is.
Oh, look, the suit did survive for it. American footage.
Oh, man. They took Joey.
He's just a little baby.
I promise you, Cat. We'll find Joey and bring him home safe and sound.
Right. Go to the electric plant. You and Ormus will meet Boohoo the Clown and the baby.
Yes, Your Highness.
I like how every time they have to call him Boohoo the Clown, they can't just call him Boohoo.
The child will destroy Angel Grove's main source of power and the Power Rangers at the very same time.
Mm.
it was. Oh no, Joey, they got him. It's all my fault.
No, Alpha, there was nothing anybody could have done.
Hey, Billy, any luck looking
unless Billy had gone.
No, I won't be able to get a lock on him until he cries again.
Oh man, come on, Joey. Now's not the time to be a good boy.
Those silly Power Rangers should have been here by now. If we could get the baby to make some noise, they could track the sound.
Brilliant!
You're too kind. Wake it! Pipe up, will ya?
Alright. Oh, he's smiling. That's cute.
They've taken him to the
he didn't do anything. He's...
Have everyone else meet us there.
Right.
Back to action. Alright, keep your eyes open. He's gotta be around her somewhere.
Look, there he is.
Huh?
Joey!
Don't worry, Joey, we'll get you!
Over here? I thought you guys would never show up! A tragedy!
And I just realized Boo-Hoo the Clown sounds a lot like...
The baby is waking from his nap and doesn't seem to have his bottle.
Hope he doesn't start crying.
Oh, that would be just...
Oh, I can't think of the name! Squat! Sounds just like Squat.
Don't worry about it, they're just trying to distract us. You guys take care of them while I take care of Joey.
You know, one of the things I like about this? See, the thing with having Zio and the fact that they're using more of the footage to save money, I guess, is also the fact that they're changing the locations. How many of Season 3's fights took place in that field outside of town? Now we're at some kind of, I don't know what you call this place, a plant, obviously. Downtown.
This baby's coming back with me.
I'm also feeling fairly confident that they go back to this place at the beginning of Turbo. Like, the first or second episode. Pouty. He's pouty. Oh no! Oh, that's terrible. That didn't even sound like him crying.
Zora, I can really use your help. Things are getting a little rough around here. You know, what we could use about now is a wee bit of firepower. Oh, I have just the thing!
See, that's still a bit different kid. Oh, right. Oh.
Joey's not here.
How'd that work?
Tommy, this is Billy. Joey's with me. He's going to be helping me.
Hi. Right. Hi, Joey. Go, he's waving.
Good job.
Thanks. You think you got us beat? Well, think again, Power Geeks! You ain't seen nothing yet! Look! Alright, guys, see your laser pistols now!
That's the first time we've seen the power sword. Nicely done. That's a cool effect, too.
I think it's time Boo-Hoo grew, do you?
I do.
Hold on, Boo-Hoo. Help is on the way.
You know, there is that one promo where the kid says the special effects are better. And I think part of that is because they're able to use more of the Sentai footage that has some of the better... special effects. Oh, here we go. I could have sworn they used the Zio cannon or whatever it's called. I guess not. Getting my episodes confused. It's been a while since I've seen Zio. Oh. Oh, that's disgusting. Nice.
That didn't go very well at all.
That was practically pretty easy.
We'll have a more diabolical device next time.
No, no doubt. Jeez.
Bye, cutie.
Yes, and I'm so glad you're back to normal.
So what are you guys going to do now?
Sleep.
Catherine and Tommy, since class ran long, I didn't get a chance to tell you how much I enjoyed your report. And I think your use of the baby was brilliant. You both get A's.
Oh, thank you so much, Mr. Toggle.
I trust you discovered taking care of a family isn't as easy as it looks.
Yeah, you know, it has its ups and downs.
I must say, though, I am looking forward to having kids of my own one day.
Well, I'm glad to hear you say that. My wife and I need a babysitter for Saturday night.
Oops.
Saturday night?
Yes, for the twins.
Twins?
Well, sure, I'd love to.
That's the spirit, Cat. After all, practice makes perfect.
Well, actually, I was hoping I could count on both of you.
Ha ha.
Oh, sure. No problem.
Good.
Ha ha ha. That'll show you, Tommy. Sure. That makes sense.
I need a new sidekick.
Funny. Alright, well that's it for that episode. That was not bad. If I could get the words out. That was a fun little episode. Much better than I remembered. Anyway, alright, so we're going to take a quick break. And when we come back, we'll come back with our second episode for today. Rangers in the Outfield. See you in a second.
Set your coordinates to Tower Rangers. See you later today after Big Bad Beetleborgs on Fox Kids.
And we're back for our second part of the episode. So let's kick this into gear, which actually is next season, not this season. Ha 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 ha. Anyway, so we're on to episode 6 of Zeal, Rangers in the Outfield. And we're going to get this started in 3, 2, 1, go. Rangers in the Outfield was the 6th episode of Power Rangers Zeo. It first aired on April 29th, 1996, written by Brett D. Bourne and directed by Robert Radler. This is a shock! Rangers in the Outfield and we're playing baseball! Ooh, with the splits. Oh, is that that kid? Wow, everyone's really good at hitting the ball. Oh, this is Tanya's boyfriend. Now, coming off the bat, it didn't look like he was going to fly that far.
Hey, Sean!
I like how he's wearing yellow.
Hey, Tanya.
SWAT.
Who?
You know, Sean.
Ooh, it's cold.
Where'd you get a weird nickname like that?
It was one of Babe Ruth's nicknames.
Oh, who's Babe Ruth?
He only holds about 50 major league records.
I'm sorry, I don't know that much about baseball. Watch out!
Whoa, did you see that?
Good catch.
Throw it out here, would you?
Ooh.
Come take a shower. Come take a shower. Come in.
I think he wants you.
Uh-oh. She's gonna have to pitch and pitch against her boy.
Did I do something wrong? Huh. You ever pitched before?
No, I've never even held a ball.
Okay, you see that guy with the funny mask on over there?
Yes?
Just throw it at him as hard as you can. Give it a shot.
Is she gonna do the whole stance and everything, even though she doesn't know how? Oh. Oh. Yep. Ooh. She's never played. She's never even held a ball, but she knows how to do the wind up. Seriously, though, one thing you don't think of California, cold enough that you can see your breath. I love how they got the choral thing coming into the music, even when they're not Rangers. Ooh, he's ticked. She catches it like she knows what she's doing.
So, what are your plans for tomorrow?
The Rangers are engaged in children's games while we sit doing nothing. A perfect opportunity. Wasted.
Make yourselves useful and come up with a plan.
If I may say so, I have come up with quite a few plans, but they always seem to be ignored.
They seem ignored because they are.
Why don't you take a stab at it, son?
Oh boy, you can count on me, Daddy.
Ooh.
I can't believe you made the baseball team. It's so cool. Thank you, Kat.
Are you kidding?
Especially the guys' baseball team. Usually they don't allow that.
Thank you, guys.
And I'm not trying to be like, you know.
Well, it looks like even the Sultan of SWAT has a weakness.
But seriously, the usually, you know, there's girls' softball.
Hey, wait. Did you guys see the type of heat?
Men's baseball.
Well, we couldn't see anything with the way your bat's swinging all over the place.
I mean, oh. I can't even imagine how embarrassing it must be to get struck out by my own girlfriend.
Very funny, you two. I'll see you guys later.
See you, Sultan. Boresata.
Okay.
Hey,
Adam's
Sean.
Still wearing his practice gear. Actually, everyone is, now that I think about it.
Adam was just telling me about Tanya's tryout. You must be really proud.
Yeah, but I'd be more proud if she struck somebody else out.
Come on, Sean, you've been struck out before.
Not by anybody I was dating.
And the way she was throwing, nobody could hit off her.
No, I could have hit. I just wasn't concentrating, that's all.
Can you give me some credit, Sean? I must have done something right for the coach to ask me to join the team.
Look, you did all right for practice, but tomorrow's game is going to be very difficult. I just hope you're ready, that's all.
She'll be ready. Come on.
Man. See what I'm saying? Jerk.
Hey, Sean. Rocky and I are supposed to meet at the batting cages tomorrow morning before the game. Do you want to meet us?
After the way I batted today, I think I could use a practice. I'll be there.
Great, we'll see you tomorrow.
All right.
Well, Dad, guess what? I've got a plan!
Oh, he came up with a plan, yay!
My own pitching machine to their practice tomorrow.
Great.
It'll pitch very special baseballs. What do you think?
Lovely. All of us could be the ball.
Absolutely, a fine idea.
I don't like it.
Well, I'm intrigued. Please, continue, my son. Go on.
You hit a ball for my pitching machine. The machine sucks you inside, then we'll capture those three and use them as bait to catch the others. And with the Rangers out of the way, you'll be free to rule the world. What do you think, Daddy? It's just brilliant.
Do you think they got a little person to be inside his costume, or do you think it's just one of those? The back is kind of open and it's just someone on their knees.
You two are no doubt wondering why you're here so early.
And of course they'd be there today. I've got a very when everyone else is going to be there.
You're being assigned Operation Refuse Removal.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, refuse.
He wants us to pick up the trash.
Woo-hoo! Here are your TP-480s.
240.
240.
And your T-150 receptacles. I will return at 1100 hours to check on your progress.
I'm enjoying these guys. I don't know. I don't know if it's they're just writing them better right now, or if it's I don't know, something to do with them being gone for a while. Hey, although I am wondering what happened to Goldar and Rito.
Come on! Who's gonna know the difference?
Wow, good job.
Skull, if you want a bat, you gotta put a token in.
Oh yeah.
Sprocket!
Excuse me!
Do you mind? My brilliant plan is about to fall apart!
But that's what I was trying to tell you! Look!
They're batting! They just better not get any hits off my machine!
Hey, do you mind? Excuse me!
Well, it's Bulk and Skull, so they probably won't. See? He's got no follow through. He's not very good at baseball, I guess.
Look.
Wonder how many times they had to do that. Oh.
I can't take a chance of getting up this before the big game. I'm gonna just have to meet you guys at practice.
Are you sure?
Yeah, man. Tell you what, you guys just don't work too hard. Save some of the home runs for Stone Canyon, all right?
All right, man. Peace. See you later.
Okay, I have to admit.
All right.
They have never shown an aptitude for baseball before.
Batter up!
Rocky Zionizer has this is like the football stuff from the season one.
Darling, would our Sprocket mind if we sent in the cogs to capture it?
Oh, I don't think so. It'll be our little gift for doing such a magnificent job with this project.
All parents should be so supportive. Don't you think so, dear?
Well, that was easy. Cool effect, too. Oh, how did they get that back?
The Zionizer now belongs to Prince Sprocket.
I love the stance thing they do. Well, it could not be going worse for Adam right now.
Come in, this is Adam.
Adam, it's Billy. What's up?
Mondo and Machina got Rocky. This pitching machine swallowed him whole. Do you have any idea where they took him?
I'm getting a reading from the other side of the park. I'll call the others and have them meet you there.
Thanks, Billy.
It's morphin' time! Zero Ranger 4!
Shouldn't he also have mentioned the whole Zionizer getting stolen?
No luck.
Guess not.
We didn't buy anything, Tanya. How about you?
No sign of the people pitcher anywhere. Man, I sure hope Rocky's all right.
Don't worry.
The pass! Welcome to our ballpark, Rangers!
If you're looking for your friend, he's safe inside the belly of the people pitcher. And soon, all of you Rangers will be...
I have to say, I do enjoy the fact that the bad guys are more inclined to come down to earth in this season. That's funny, we haven't even seen Tommy this whole episode. How is it not getting damaged? Okay. He got it, cool. Whoa! Is this supposed to move that fast? This feels like a later series episode. What makes me think that is, one, they're at a park, and two, this seems like a sillier episode, which they got sillier later in the series due to a terrorist attack on the trains in Japan. During the course of this series,
Oh, Tommy, are you all right?
Yeah, I think so.
Man, am I glad to see you.
Boy, you got short though.
I brought you a present. Oh, my Zeonizer. Thanks. Good call.
Yeah.
It's morphin' time. Zeo Ranger 3, blue.
If we could just reverse these gears, maybe we can get out of here. Give me a hand, Rocky. Turn them.
You got it. I think it might be working.
So wait a minute. They built a gear set just for a couple minutes of them being inside of it? Wow. Impressive. Them getting out seemed a little easy too. It had to be. This has to have been like a two-parter or something. It's so slow.
Ready when you are, play.
Around and around and off you go.
You need some help.
Anybody want to try my fastball?
Time for some Zeozords. Actually, it can't be too late in the series. I don't know if they're using the Zeo Megazord.
Send this people pitcher right to the showers. Zeo 5 battle helmet, ready.
Hey, better, better.
Ooh.
Battle helmet activated. Here, let me give you a lift.
Oh, this must be a Blue Ranger focus episode. Nice.
Well, this is it, folks. Still a cannon is down to the last town. Unfortunately for the Angel Grove Tigers, who lead by a score of 1-0, this is the heart of the Bears' order.
All right.
I'm thinking this was from the episode The Stolen Transformation Brace. It's the 17th episode of O-Ranger.
Yeah, that fight took a lot out of her. Thanks to King Mondo.
Yeah, it's obvious he's not a fan of baseball.
That sounded like she said that fart took a lot out of her. Come on, Tanya. Now they're starting to boo her.
Looks like Angel Grove's rookie pitcher might be getting a little tired out there.
But if they catch it. Okay, it sounded like Tanya just told the guy to hold up at second. Or third. Billy Thompson. The career average of 527 and 80 home runs. He also holds 5 state records for hitting. Oh boy. Right, you got 2 down, guys! 2 I do not know how to commentate on sports on TV. But it's not the last time we'll have baseball on Power Rangers. I can think of at least one more time. During the Zordon era. Now that kind of looked like a foul. Oh, Rocky saved the day! Good job, Rocky! See, baseball is a team sport.
Yeah, that was a nice game. Although, you almost blew it.
What are you talking about?
You almost gave up the whole game in the ninth inning.
She only had a one-run lead.
Yeah!
And our offense didn't give her anything.
Man, come on. We won this game by luck. Forget it. We'll just talk about this later.
No,
man.
I don't think so.
Ooh, this
See,
is it.
Since I joined this team, you've given me nothing but negative attitude. If you cannot support me, then I don't think there's anything else we need to discuss. Period.
Ooh.
Well, fine. That's the way you want to play it. It's cool with me.
That was awesome. I'm proud of you.
Yeah, it was a good game, wasn't it?
Not the game. You stood up for yourself. And that was really cool.
Good job, Tanya.
He didn't deserve you.
Thanks, Adam. You're the best.
You can easily see why a lot of people want to put the two of them together. Ooh, she hit the guy.
I will return at 1100 hours to check on your progress.
Here's the big one.
Yeah, they're having more fun then, I guess. All right, well, that's going to do it for today's episode. That was two more episodes of Zio Down. Next time we'll watch the next two episodes, Every Dog Has His Day and The Puppet Blaster. So tune in next week, and I will see you then. Y'all have a good and safe week. Take care. Thank you for listening to Ranger Chronicles. Feedback for the show can be sent to prchronicles@gmail.com, or feel free to leave a comment at the show's posting at powerrangerchronicles.com. All images and music heard on the show are copyright their respective holders and are meant to help celebrate the Power Rangers. No infringement is intended.
Power Rangers is copyright Hasbro Entertainment. This show is dedicated to all the men and women, both in front of the camera and behind the scenes, who have worked to bring us Power Rangers for over 25 years. Ranger Chronicles is a proud member of the Two True Freaks Internet Radio Network. Please be sure to stop by twotruefreaks.com to check out more great shows. Thanks again for listening, and good night.